Hi there!
Hey!
It's been a while we did the video. Actually, it's not too long, maybe a couple of weeks, but we would like to use this opportunity to thank the viewers here. We have hit more than 3,000 views. 3,000 views last week. We're so excited for this because we didn't think we would hit there so quick.
So today's vlog, we'll be commenting some of your comments that we have from our videos.
First video, we're like comments on the comments. Will be the video, you know, between a few months ago actually. No, more than a few months ago.
Yeah.
So this is for Phoenix the Hamster. The comments was, holy shit, it's like something out of Dragon Ball Z. I'm Canadian. Holy shit, it's like something out of Dragon Ball Z. What do you think?
The whole script, everything, the action scenes are completely original. Like, seriously, I haven't even seen Dragon Ball Z. I don't know what you're talking about, bro. Alright, next one is coming from the video of 5 things that annoys foreigners living in Hong Kong. And this is the video basically we got the most views, so thanks so much for watching. I think we hit about 1,100 views, something like that. Alright, this one is from Heavenly Cat Lover 3. Alright. Meow. Okay, she or he said, she or
I don't know.
It's actually pretty accurate. And it's true, when you're a foreigner, you can't haggle in a market. So most foreigners end up going to big supermarkets, which cost more. I don't know, agree to disagree. I mean, in my case, I look like a local anyway, so maybe I can get away with it if I try to haggle or try my best with my broken Cantonese. So I don't know, what do you think?
Depends where you go, you know. If you go to the ladies' market, usually just ask for half price and work your way back up.
And it's not just that. I mean, lots of foreigners, they just stuck in Central, and they would never go anywhere else.
Okay, this is from Joe Ree. He said, "Yep, true and funny. You forgot about the elevator though. Lift, you know. People run past and hit the close button so you will miss it. Just in case you're on the lower level." Oh, and the left side of the escalator is for walking, not for standing next to someone yapping away. I can totally relate to this comment because I hate when people just press the close button before...
It's around your face, isn't it?
Yeah, or like, you know, like you try to get in there and you're pressing close already. Or when before you even step out of the elevator, their finger is on the close button. Like, you know what, next time I'm gonna like, walk halfway at the door and then press close it and it hit my body and then yell at them. What do you think?
I agree. I think it happened to me once or twice. Alright, next one from Carlos Doe. Yeah, famous YouTuber.
Carlos Doe.
Anyway, if you don't know Carlos Doe, he's probably one of the most famous, can we call it Hong Kong YouTubers, I guess? He's Canadian, but he's really into Hong Kong culture and like most of his videos are in Cantonese. And yeah, hopefully in the future we're gonna do some collaboration with him, so hopefully. He said, the wrong number of things happen to me all the time. I actually purposely speak English, so they want to hang up on me instead of me hanging up on them. Ha ha. Well, in my case, I can't speak Cantonese anyway, so just like in the skits, I would just say, hello, English please, and they would just, wrong number. What do you think?
Well, I pretend I can't speak Chinese. So I say, I always, when I see a number that kind of like advertising, I just answer in English. And then they just like, I say hello, and then it's like, oh, hello, Mr. Chow. And then I'll be like, do you speak English?
Oh, wrong number. Well, what do you think? Leave it in the comments.
Okay, this is commenting on the latest video, the 5 things that annoy foreigners. Indonesian.
The sequel.
Okay, this is from HK Funla.
HK Funla.
Yeah, HK Funla. Okay, anyways. Oh, it's a very simple question. How long have you lived in Hong Kong? So how long have you lived in Hong Kong? Quick background, in case you don't know, I was born here and And then I moved to Canada when I was young, lived there for almost 15 years, moved back 8 years ago. So yeah, you do the math. And you?
Well, in my case, I was born and raised in Jakarta, Indonesia. And then my family and I moved to Wellington, New Zealand when I was 16, 17. And then just recently moved to Hong Kong a couple of years ago. So yeah, hence third culture.
Third culture.
Third culture.
Third culture.
Third culture. Subscribe! Another one from the same video, from Derek in Canada.
Canada!
Hi, Derek in Canada!
Yeah,
Canada.
Yeah.
Hey?
No.
Anyway. A? But in New Zealand, called A?
A.
No. It's good A.
Yeah, A.
You like A?
No, no A.
Alright. Anyway, he said, as usual, that was great, thanks. If everyone had the same sense of humor you guys have, the world would be much better place.
Whoa.
That was very deep, man.
That's deep, man. We didn't know how humor can change the world.
Yeah. Thanks, Derek.
What's that Michael Jackson song again?
Heal the world.
Heal the world.
Something wrong.
Oh, crap. I can't sing.
Make it a better place.
Please.
For you and for me and the
entire something. Chinese people.
Alright, that's it for today's vlog. And yeah, please keep the comments going. We need more comments, good or bad. We'll respond to it. We'll make fun of it maybe. And I'll be on holiday for the next 3 weeks. So hopefully as soon as I come back then, we'll make new video. And yeah, stay tuned.
Yeah, watch out. Yeah.